Mom, I want to move in with Chad. I love Chad. Chad can do no wrong. And you're like, no, girl, Chad's going to get you pregnant. Hey, beautiful people, welcome back. So let's go ahead and get something clarified real quick. Y'all see this sunshine right here? What the hell? I have tried to block the little hole that it keeps coming through. And I don't know if you guys realize this, but like the sun moves. So every time I get this hole blocked off, it just like moves a centimeter and poof, comes through the window. So I apologize per usual that this is happening. I promise one of these days I'll like just commit to pulling the blind down all the way, but I can't do that right now. I just mentally, I can't do it. I need the sun. Like my body is like aching for that little, oh, sun. Like I need it, but like my camera doesn't like it. So like my apologies on the slight visual disturbance. I know for a lot of you, it can be kind of distracting, but like for my soul, it's a big A plus. So I'm sorry, but like, I'm also not sorry. You know, let's kind of take that and leave it where it is. But going into today's video, I'm so freaking excited because I have basically a full face of new-ish makeup, and there's a lot of little caveats to that. So first things first, I have been holding on and not playing with, I'm so proud of myself, I've been holding on to the new Hourglass Concealer, the new Urban Decay Primer, Urban Decay Powder. So while I was already excited about those items, I figure we might as well sit down and talk about some other stuff too. So I have, I'm just, as you can see, it's all like laying there because this whole section over here covered in crap. So like, the mess keeps extending down the table. I'd like to apologize, but it's just who I am. I'm very unorganized in this part of my life for a Libra. It's weird. But anyways, I digress. Moral of the story. Today, we have the new stuff, Urban Decay Hourglass. We also have new stuff from BoxyCharm that I haven't tried, just like random stuff that's come in the last few months. I have a couple of things here from Benefit that were sent to me in PR. And what else is there? I have some drugstore makeup as well that I picked up. There's a couple of things from Flower Beauty, and I was just excited to test them out. So that's what we're getting into today. I'm going to stop talking because this part of my existence is just, I don't shine in the intro. So if you ever click off during the intro, you need to give me a chance. Let me get to the meat and potatoes, the middle of the video, y'all. I'm all about meat. Don't I look like somebody that's all about meat and potatoes? Let me get to where I'm good. Let me get to application. Let me get to the middle where I'm sweating. I'm already sweating. Who are we kidding? Ooh, girl, let's just move the camera in. Let's get going. I'm sweating. Let's go. Whew. Okay, guys, we're good. We're zoomed in. There's still sunshine peeking around, and I don't care because it's time for primer. Oh, and as promised, I am so freaking excited to try this. This is the new Urban Decay All Nighter Face Primer, and it says it is good for long wear foundation grip, and it preps, smooths, and perfects. Guys, I just love the way Urban Decay writes. Like a stage 5 clinger, the All Nighter Face Primer grips your foundation and won't want to let it go. Our lightweight formula goes on sheer to perfect your skin, leaving it feeling smooth, hydrated, and slightly lifted. Like a stage 5 clinger. I love that. So let's go ahead here. Let's take it apart. I actually like this little squeezy tube, and I like the look of it, like the aesthetic overall on this, I really like. And then I'm gonna pump out about yay much. I'm mainly gonna, I think, keep this in the T-zone because that's where I'm oily lately. No smell at all. Okay, we're just gonna wipe that under the T-zone. Ooh, it absorbs quickly. Okay. For some reason, I envisioned this being something that like sat on the skin as opposed to something that like sank in more like a lotion. That's interesting. Okay, well, I guess that was a little bit more anticlimactic than I had originally thought. So while that sinks in, let's move on to the rest of the face. And for that, I have this little ditty. This is from Farsali. It is their Liquid Glass Radiance Serum with Hyaluronic Acid. And I did get this in a BoxyCharm. And this I'm gonna primarily keep like on the outer portions of my face. So like out there, out here, and then like on the outer brim of my forehead or my five head in this case, because y'all know I got one hell of a forehead going on. Looking up close at both primers, I don't really see any difference. I do feel like the center of my face does have a little bit of, like I can feel the smoothness from the Urban Decay primer, but it doesn't feel like overly tacky or grippy or anything. But the serum on the outskirts of the face does look nice and illuminated. It's a very light, you can actually see it a little bit right there. It's a very light look, but I do like it. And I actually really like the way that it like presses into the skin. Now really quickly, before I get into the foundation and all of that, you guys saw a few videos ago, I used a YSL concealer to go in and like do a little spot concealing. And I really love that concealer for it. But I thought for today, I found this in a box. BoxyCharm, or like in my BoxyCharm bin rather. And this is a concealer that they sent from Pretty Vulgar, and it's in the shade 60, Little White Lies. And I thought maybe we could use this for a little spot concealing. It's definitely darker than my one from YSL, but I still wanted to try to get some use out of it. And then I'm just gonna go in here with the Real Techniques. This is that same 221 brush, and I'm gonna keep it on minimum because this is, again, one of those adjustable brushes that you can move up and down. And I like to keep it on the fluffiest setting so I can just kind of buff and pat that that concealer in. Yeah, this is definitely way darker than the YSL. The coverage, like if I'm just kind of comparing it for what I'm used to using, the coverage is not as nice. I like the one from YSL better. I feel like I get a little bit better coverage and it's not as thick as this one. This one definitely feels a little bit thicker on my skin. All right, so normally at this point in time, I would just start going in foundation, concealer, the Huge. But for today, I wanna use my Zoeva foundation. I've been using this a ton. I really love it. But the only caveat is that the shade I have this in is 050N, which is the shade Beautiful. And it's way too dark for me and it does oxidize a little bit darker even. So before I go in with that, I wanted to check in with my Hourglass concealer, which I picked this up in the shade Birch. Yeah, guys, I'm really glad that I checked because this concealer is unbelievably light. Okay, it's fine. I can make this work. I'm just gonna need to like re-establish some boundaries. So here's what we're gonna do, guys. Given the shade of this, I think we're gonna go Scott Barnes method today. And we're going to, oh wait, don't people not use a lot of this? Oh, that might've been too much. Okay, it's fine. So I do the same thing on the other side. Wow, Paige. Okay, it's fine. Me. It's fine, it's fine, it's fine. I just keep telling myself it's fine until that's my reality. It's fine. So I'm gonna go in and blend this out. This is just a damp Real Techniques sponge here. Oh, I like that. Okay, that's really pretty. Like, I was actually shocked because it looks, from what I can see without my glasses on, because y'all know I'm a little bit, you know, visually challenged. It looks gorgeous on the fuzzy monitor I can see, and it looks really nice up close. Like, oh, I like that a lot. Okay. Okay, so that's that under the eyes. I absolutely love the way it looks. Okay. Right, now, what I'm doing, as you can see, I just lightly kind of placed a tiny bit of it over the other areas of my face that I need it to be a little bit lighter. So I'm just going in and doing like a little pre-color contouring because when I go in with foundation, because that shade is so dark, it'll really darken these areas. By going in and using just a little bit of this concealer, it kind of helps lighten those areas and make it so I don't need as much foundation there. And I know it looks a little bit crazy right now, guys, I know, but I promise stay with me and it'll be okay. Now, I went back and forth on this one, but I did decide I'm going to go in with a little bit of the Chanel Soleil bronzer. I've used this a billion times on my channel. And then this is just the BH Cosmetics number 2 brush. And I'm going to go in and just very lightly kind of map out a little bit of this onto my face. And then after going in, we've added in the foundation just to like the rest of the areas. I blended it down onto the jawbone a little bit. I am noticing right up in the under eye bag region that I lost a little coverage. So I think for my under eye type specifically, this will be a concealer that I have to set sooner rather than later. So I just went ahead and I applied a little bit more just to give me that fresh face again. Now really quickly, I'm just taking a little bit of my Maybelline Fit Me in 05 Fair and I am lightly setting the under eye because that area desperately needs to be set. And then I'm also gonna take a little bit of that Maybelline Fit Me powder and I'm going to press it into my big old Hulk wrinkle right there. Oh my good Lord, you need to just sit down, little hulky girl, come on. Oh, she gets so frustrated. She's like that temperamental little like 16-year-old girl that's like, Mom, I want to move in with Chad. I love Chad. Chad can do no wrong. And you're like, no, girl, Chad's going to get you pregnant. Just went, that got very, very serious very quickly. And then per usual, I'm also going to set my nose with my sponge. And I'm also going to move on and set my chin and my smile lines around my mouth right here. Okay, so I very lightly brought my hair off the back of my neck because I think I'm actually gonna sweat to death. Oh, wow. And then I also took the liberty of trying to move myself up farther as to be out of the sun. So if you and I get so close that eventually like a baby just pops out, it's just, it is what it is, I'm sorry. Because I just, I'm just sweating. And I could take off the sweater, but I don't want to because I like the sweater. It's very complicated being me. Anyways, who cares? It's time to go ahead and move on to the next product. So at this point we have our T-zone set, but the rest of my face is unset. And for that, we are going to use the Urban Decay Stay Naked The Fix powder. This is what it is. And it does come with one of these little flippy doobies, but we're not even looking at her. Cause instead we're gonna use my Scott Barnes here. This is the Scott Barnes 67 brush. And we're just going to dab this in here. We're gonna pop it on our face and see how well this goes. Now for application of this, obviously obviously I'm using a very fine amount of it. So I'm not really testing this as a powder foundation, and I'm not really testing the coverage along those same lines. I'm more so just testing how it looks on the skin and how it works as a setting powder. But if you wanted to obviously test it out as a powder foundation, you could try that too. Okay, but with that on and applied, guys, I'm gonna tell you right now, as a setting powder so far, 10 out of 10, I love it. I think it looks so, so nice on my skin, and it gives this really beautiful, like, soft effect, especially over, like, my cheek region right through here. It looks like a really nice, soft, matte finish. It's not, like, overbearing. It doesn't look dry, crusty, cakey, and it didn't, like, cake on. And as I'm just sitting here kind of, like, looking and playing around with the consistency, it is super, super finely milled, like, on a really satisfying level. It feels like silk. This is really nice. Where's my cell phone at? Paige, I don't know. Could it be under your mega thigh right there? Wow. I literally have my cell phone tucked under my leg. Like, it's like, if this is my leg, it was like tucked right under the edge, like sticking out. And I'm like, where's my cell phone? Right there, Paige. Literally right there. Wow. Wow. All right, so at this point, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna move through bronzer, blush, and highlight. I have a new one that I wanna test out for all of them. And this one I picked up from Flower Beauty, so obviously it is on the more drugstore side, but I thought it looked super duper pretty. And here's a little swatch of it. I actually like the fact that the luminescence part, it isn't like super overwhelming. My only concern, just based on the undertone, because, yeah, the luminous isn't a problem. It's a really nice, light, little glinty kind of look. But my only concern is the undertone. It looks a little bit yellow, but we're going to give it a shot. And with that, we're going to use, actually, my dual fiber brush from It Cosmetics here. This is, does it say what it is? It says that it's their blurring powder brush, but it's just any dual fiber. It's just a nice, loose one. And I love using these, especially when it says that it's a luminous bronzer, because I have to be super careful how much I apply. All right, so as you can see, I just went in pretty light-handed with this, and I think that was definitely for the better. I like the color, but I can definitely tell that if I were to, like, actually build this up to be a really intense bronzer, it would look way too yellow undertone for me. But at the color that it's at right now, I actually think it looks perfect. All right, so I tried to, like, move the camera out and do some changing. I don't know if it helped or not, but this is just so you guys can get a better picture of where we are. And at that, it is time for blush, and I have this little guy right here. It is from Ciate, and this is their Marbled Light Illuminating Blusher, and it's in the shade Halo. And this and the highlight are both from Ciate, and they're both out of my BoxyCharm, just so you guys know. And it looks a little something like this. So this is one of my favorite colors for a blush. It's like a mauvey pink color. This or a coral, girl, all day long. Ugh. And to apply this, I'm gonna go in and use my Wayne Goss. This is, I think, one of his special edition brushes from like 2 years ago, so it doesn't have a number or anything on it, but it's just a really nice, like, fluffy, very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Very sparse brush. It's meant to give you, like, a really nice flushed application, and I love using this for blushes. So I'm just gonna go in here, grab a little bit, and then get to going on the blush. Okay, so I've went ahead and I'm kind of just, like, working it all over at this point with this brush, kind of fluffing it. And the only thing I can say about this blush is that it looks like it belongs on my face. And I don't know if that's a weird thing to say or not about a blush, because I've never said it before, but it looks like it belongs. Like, it's the perfect tone. It matches so nicely with the bronzer. It blends in with the bronzer stunningly. It looks really good with my skin tone. Like, I love this color. That looks so good, right? Like, am I the only, oh my, I love this, wow. All right, so next up, we're gonna move into brows, and both items were sent to me from Benefit. One of them I have talked about a ton on my channel. This is their Precisely My Brow in shade 4. I absolutely love this pencil. I've used it a ton. But for the other item, this is the one I haven't used before. This is their 3D Brow Tones, and it says that it gives you subtle brow enhancing highlights. This is also in the shade 4, and it says that brows come to life with this brush on highlighting gel. It instantly enhances your natural brow color with subtle highlights and a soft contrast. It highlights your natural brow hair. It is water resistant, 12-hour wear. You can wear it alone or over a brow pencil. All right, guys, so I'm back. Brows are finished. The pencil obviously went fine. I've used that 1,000 times. And as far as the 3D brow tones goes, I don't hate this, actually. Like, I kind of, it's nothing you can see on camera, but I kind of like the way that it does really emphasize and, like, individualize your lashes, especially for me, or not your lashes, your brows, especially in the front right here. I feel like they look really nice and feathered, and I'm not exactly sure how they're doing it, But there's like something about it where it really does work. Like they look very, like you can see each individual hair, which for somebody like me who has like, I don't know, 7 combined brow hairs between both sides, it's kind of nice to be able to like see them and be like, oh, hey there, little Bethany, what's going on, Tammy? Like I can see them and it's kind of nice. From there, let's go ahead and move on. I'm gonna take a little bit of the Hourglass concealer and I am going to lightly prime both of my eyelids. So now that we're moving into eyeshadow, I have this palette right here. This is from Flower Beauty and it's their Jungle Lights palette. And of course I picked it up just like everyone else saw in Kathleen Light's video where she like raved over it. I was like, well, now I need to try it because guys, sparkles will always win my heart and soul. So let's go ahead and swatch some of the, whoa. Oh my, these are, okay. I mean, like, okay, wow. Oh my gosh, these are super satisfying. Wow, who did these swatches? Look at what I just did. Like, who am I? I don't know, I've never done this before. Guys, these are so freaking gorgeous. And I'm gonna go ahead and just run through my crease some of the Flower Beauty bronzer. Okay, so I'm really struggling because Basic Paige wants to go in with like that gold shade or this like really pretty copper shade, but then Not Basic Paige really wants this green, like all over her lip, ooh! And I think that might be the color that I go with because it's super pretty. And I'm wondering, like, do I need a glitter glue with these? I feel like I don't because they're so rich. So we're gonna go ahead and just try it. I'm just gonna like, oh wow. Oh man, I barely touched that to my eye and it was like instant perfection. Oh, that's so pretty. I think right in the center of that, I'm gonna go in with the gold shade just for a little added dimension. Ooh, also very pretty. Okay, I'm gonna take this shade up a little higher and then I'm gonna take a little bit of the lightest gold because why not at this point? And we're gonna put that even tighter on the inside of that gold shade just to keep building that color depth there. Then go in and kind of blend that with the green. Okay, I'm sorry, but that's absolutely pretty. I'm just going in, this is a BH number, what is this, a 6? Yeah, this is the BH6 and there's no product on it. I'm just lightly blending at the top here, those gold shades. That is so, so pretty. Oh my word. Who can even remember that they just accidentally smudged green literally all over their entire face? Not me, that's for sure. Then I wiped it on my pants. Also don't care, you know why? Because look at that. Oh, it's so good. I'm also gonna take just on my finger here a little bit of that green shade as well and run that on the bottom lash line. Just a freckle. And then I'm taking a little bit of the lightest gold shade as well and I'm running that just under the tear duct there, just to open it up a little bit. And I'm gonna pop a little bit in the inner corner. Holy crap, guys, believe me when I tell you, the camera is dulling how bright that inner corner is. Oh my gosh, this shade right here is not playing around. Like, whew, girl, so good. All right, so next up, I'm gonna take some of this black eyeliner. This is the L'Oreal Age Perfect Black Eyeliner. I just did a full review of this. I wanna say like the middle of last week sometime. I'll link it up here. The whole collection, the foundation, concealer, liners, all that good stuff, it's in that video. So check it out if you're curious. But I'm gonna take this and I am going to smudge it into the upper lash line and waterline. And then I think maybe a little bit onto the lower as well. Am I the only one that when I wear green on my lids and it's like this and it's like shimmery and like really cute and it has like this like grungy green shimmer type feel, am I the only one that feels like the sexiest reptile on the planet? Because I feel like I'm like, damn girl, you make them lizards go crazy. Like that's just the vibe I get and I don't know if it's just me or not. So you can just, you know, leave your thoughts and opinions down below on that one. And I'm gonna go ahead and spray my face here. This is the Morphe Setting Spray. And then from there, it's finally time to go ahead and move on to highlight. This is from Ciate. This is the Confetti Highlighter. Wow, that's way too dark for me. Oh, honey. No. Like, look at... Are you kidding? Yeah, that's okay. Nope. Okay. So that'll get passed on to a friend of mine. I actually have someone in mind and they will look so pretty in that. Oh my God. Yeah, not me though. Oh, definitely not me. All right. Oh my God. Wouldn't you know it? My Jaclyn Hill highlight, my quad right here. It's like, it was just sitting right in front of me. It's so weird. It's almost like I absolutely love it. So I'm going to go ahead and just dive into these two lighter shades right here. I like how I'm like, I'm just going to dive into these two light shades. Like, Paige, calm down. These two right here. Put those on your face. Okay. And lately, completely fun fact, if you're wondering, like, Paige, what the hell is that giant thing in your hand? This is the Morphe Y8, and it is, like, such a large, dense brush, but I have been loving this to apply this highlight, because the highlight itself is so nice and finely milled that when I go in with this brush, I can just like buff it into my skin, similar to how I would buff in like a finishing powder or even like a liquid foundation, how I always like to buff those in circular motions with a brush, similar to that. And it looks so skin-like, but so perfect on the, like, it's perfect. All right, and then next up, I've got this little guy. This I pulled out of my BoxyCharm bin as well. This is the Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Ultra Fine Mist, and I have never tried this before. I've heard rave reviews about it, though. Ooh, and I like that mist. You hear that? Ooh, that's nice. Let's go ahead and give this face a little spritz here. All right, guys, so change of plans. I had to move everything again because the sun was just impossible. So I'm way far back now, and I was talking to you guys about the Glow Recipe Spray, which I did, oh God, hello, no thank you. I did spray it on my face though, and I like the mist, and I love the lightness of it. But as I've mentioned before on my channel, I do have to have like a little bit of a wetter spray to really press all my layers together. I've already used the Morphe Continuous. I use that one a ton. And the other one that I love is my NYX Bare With Me spray. So I'm just gonna give myself a few little spurts of this. Mm. And it's not to say that there's anything wrong with the one from Glow Recipe. It's nothing like that. For me, it's just more so, it's so light on my skin that it doesn't really press everything together. And especially at the end of like the entire routine, I really have to have that nice wet press. Now, really quickly, also from the L'Oreal Age Perfecting line, I'm gonna grab the lip liner. This is the anti-feathering lip liner in the shade 10. Bright Mocha. All right, guys, so change of plans. I put the entire lip liner on and then I was like, it's a little bit too much. So I wiped off the majority of it and I left like the essence behind. And over top of it, I'm just gonna go in with this little gloss here. It's from Fenty. And this is out of the kit that they released, or the little gloss collection they released at Christmas time. And this is in the shade Hot Chocolate. All right, beautiful people, this is the finished look. I hope that you guys loved it and had a lot of fun watching. I'm gonna go ahead and get into the highlights really quickly. But I also wanted to mention, did anybody else happen to notice that I completely forgot mascara? Because I didn't. I didn't realize it until I was like getting ready to do my close-ups and I'm like, something looks off. Something looks different. And then it occurred to me, my lashes were non-existent. So I went ahead and I threw on a couple of coats of my L'Oreal Age Perfect, also from the Age Perfect video that I've referenced 100 times now. So if you want to check that out, you can see the video. But that's the mascara I used. And like I said, that was the only thing missing to complete the full face. So let's go ahead and jump in really quickly. I want to give you guys the up close of how everything came together. That way we can talk complexion and kind of run through the products really quickly. And I think with that, I want to jump in to my standout product, which is by a landslide, the Hourglass Concealer. That stuff is absolutely beautiful on my skin. I really, really love the way that it like delivers coverage, but it has such a beautiful, thin, like skin-like effect. And I think that product in and of itself really did set up the entire face for me as far as being a really beautiful, natural looking skin, like complexion day. Now the primer, as of right now, I'm not noticing anything that's like crazy outstanding about that, but I did like the way that it absorbed into the skin, and I think that's the type of product that I won't notice anything about until later. So I'll definitely keep you guys updated down below in the description box on that. As far as my entire full face is looking right now, there's only one area that I do see any issue, and it's my Hulk wrinkle right up here, which just tells me I would have to be more mindful when using these products and really setting that quicker. And that could just be because after I applied the concealer to my T-zone right through here, I didn't set it quickly enough. It could be something as simple as that. All right, you guys, with that, that is the end of the video. I hope that you liked it and that it was fun. And this little sexy sparkly little lizard here is off to go purchase, I don't know what kind of like old lady things. Maybe I need popsicles or scrunchies or yarn or something. So I'm gonna go do my day. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Like I said, leave me all of your thoughts and opinions down below. If you haven't checked me out yet on Instagram and on Twitter, they will both be linked in the description. And if you haven't subscribed, please be sure to do that as well. I do upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and those go up between 6 and 7 a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. And you guys, that is it. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have a great day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! My hair is at the most awkward length right now. Do you see how she doesn't want to listen? Do you see how she does not want to listen to me? It's really rude of you to not listen when mother says to listen, okay? Oh, that's not acceptable. Hey, beautiful people, welcome back. Today we're doing. Hey, beautiful people, welcome back. So today I'm. What is? I feel like I'm doing interpretive dance.